it going? Good to see you again. This is week two, day one. So we're starting a whole new set of exercises, and we're also starting a new sports theme. This week is going to be track and field. It's not all going to be about running, only maybe like one or two days we're going to involve running. What other type of sports are in track and field?
There's high jump, long jump.
Pole vaulting?
Yeah, pole vaulting.
Javelin, javelin, throws, yeah. Discus,
yeah. Shot put. So many different things are within track and field. And we're just going to skim on the surface of just a few of the skills that you could use within track and field this week. I think that makes sense. Anyway, let's go ahead and start with our warm-up exercises. Same warm-ups. All right, arm circles for five. One, two, three, four, and five. Take it forward. Five, four, three, two, and one. Other side, backwards. One, two, three, four, five. Take it forwards. Five, four, three, two, one. Now reach down and touch your toes. Opposite arm. I am tight. Mm-hmm. So by now you should be feeling a little bit stronger, maybe a little bit more confident with working out if you did the week prior. Let's do one more. All right, now hug your knee. Bring it up. Do y'all feel sore?
No.
No, and yes. Where are you feeling sore, Ethan?
My legs.
Your legs? I'm feeling sore in my legs too. I did lunges yesterday. Last one. All right, now let's stretch our these muscles. What are these muscles?
Quadriceps.
Quadriceps. Good. And we're adding an arm raise to stretch these muscles. What are these muscles?
Pectoralis major.
Pectoralis muscles. Good. There's a major and a minor in there. Let's do one more. All right, now let's stretch our gluteus maximus. Lift your leg up by its ankle. And you can kind of lift up on the knee too if you want. You feel that?
Yep.
Good. So with our warm-up stretches, we don't want to hold them for too long because we're trying to get the blood flowing. And you don't want to strain any muscles because your muscles are cold when you're starting out. All right, last stretch. Runner stretch. And rotate. Good. Other side. And let's do one more set of that. Good. Okay. Great job. We're going to introduce you to four new exercises. We're going to start with hollow tuck rocks. So let's go down to the ground. These are going to work our abdominal muscles. You're going to put yourself in a tuck position, looks like this. To make it harder, you can extend your arms out like this. And we're just going to rock back and forth. We're going to do this 15 times. Okay, get ready and go. One, two, three, four. Good. Again, to make it harder, you can put your arms up. Six. And that will be by your ears. Seven. Eight. Good. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. Let's do three more. 13. 14. 15. Awesome. Now, you're going to need like a chair or even a couch or an ottoman, something to do chair dips on. You can do this on the floor too, and I'll do it on the floor just in case you don't have anything, but it's more effective if you can get up in a chair. So, you're going to sit on your hands. Go ahead and show them how to sit on their hands. And then you're going to walk out, and then you're going to just bend your elbows. So all of the focus should be in that upper back portion of your arm. What are these muscles called?
Triceps.
All right. Here, I'll come in front of you. And we're gonna do 10 of these. Ready? And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. You should have definitely felt that in the back of your arms. All right, now stand up again. We're gonna do 15 air squats. And that just means squats without weight. And I want you to try to tap the ground every time with your fingertips. And go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Try to keep your back straight. 5, 6, chest up. 7, 8, 15, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, good. All right, you should have felt those in your legs for sure. Last exercise is the non-burpee walkout. So we're not going down to a push-up. You're just putting your hands on the ground, then you're stepping back to a plank, and then stepping back up. Okay, so it looks like this. Let's do 10 of those. Ready, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, one more. 10, great job. We're gonna go through all of those exercises two more times. So back to hollow tuck rocks. Here we go, 15, and go. 1, 2, now that we know, let's go a little bit faster. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, only 5 more. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Awesome. Chair dips for 10. I'm getting warm. Now taking off the, get it off. Okay. All right, 10 chair dips. Get ready. And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Air squats for 15. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep that head up. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Non-burpee walkouts. And go. Just for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 more. Good. 3 more. 2 more. Last one. Woo! Great job. Grab some water if you need it. Last set. Going right back into those hollow tuck rocks. Now, another way you can make these a little bit harder, if they're too easy for you at home, is to extend your legs as well as your arms. So it looks like this. Okay? You can try that if you want. All right. Ready? Last set. And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, keep it going, 7, 8, 14, 15. Just one more exercise. Non-burpee walkouts for 10. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cardio section. We have two different exercises for our cardio portion. The first one is going to be bum kickers. You're just going to kick your bum with your heels. Okay? Then the next thing that we're going to do are vertical jumps. So you're just going to jump as high as you can over and over for 20 seconds. All right, so 20 seconds of work, 10 seconds of rest, and then we swap exercises. So get ready. We're going to start those bum kickers right now and go. Kicking your booty. There we go. Yeah. guessing that you know I could never duck. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Done with that section. Go ahead, grab a sip of water, and get ready for our track and field drill.
All right, so we're ready for our next drill. So in track and field, you do a lot of jumping. So today we're gonna do a drill called Jump Max. Get a measuring tape and measure out 15 feet, and then at the end of the measuring tape, put either two cones or stuffed animals or cups or whatever you have to create a marker. The kids are gonna take turns one by one, seeing how many few jumps it takes them to go from one cone to the next. So you're doing broad jumps in a sense. All right, let's see how many times it takes them. They're gonna get 2 to 3 times to try this out. All right, Juliet, go for it. So you don't get a running start, you start at the cone and then you jump as far as you can. Okay. Stay there and then jump again. You're seeing how many jumps it takes for you to get to the purple cone. Oh, so close. So 2 and a quarter.
Yeah.
All right, go for it, Ethan. Nice. Oh, so close. You almost made it. All right, Juliet's turn. Juliet, now do it with your feet together. Like a broad jump.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Oh, that's good. Good. So that was 3. And Ethan's turn, see if he can beat his last score. Those shoes should help you jump a little bit. Oh yeah, I say you got it for sure, 2. All right.
Ready?
Dad's trying.
Is it on?
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, wow. I almost touched.
Oh, that's good.
Did I beat him?
Yeah, you beat Ethan.
Oh. I think that was you.
No, he beat you.
Almost.
Well, these shoes stick really good. They're very heavy, but they don't slide.
Oh, you should try in running shoes. See if there's a difference.
Nope.
See you tomorrow.